How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? This is my regular blog. I want to take to you a couple of things that are very interesting. Now, you're always accustomed to me just offering an opinion about one certain thing. Now I'm talking more about the state of our country itself. What is wrong with it with this country that we can't seem to pick the best people for president that we could possibly find? Why do we always take compromised characters whose only qualification is that they look good or the right weight, the right height, the right speech, everything is right except their minds. Their minds are the only thing that is not working. Historians say that we only had maybe a handful of really exceptionally qualified people who were the presidents of the United States out of all the presidents we ever had. Why does that happen? What is wrong with America? And it's exactly happening right now. Here's a perfect example of why we always wind up with one kind of a turkey or another as a president of the United States. The main people who qualify for president of the United States is nobody mentions, like the Democratic Party examples of Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama. Would you say that if you took all the best minds with the best experience in America to handle all the foreign policy problems that we have in this country, all the threats of war, all the threats all over the world that are taking place and all the ramifications involved in it that require so much knowledge, intelligence, and history and wisdom, would that Barack Obama or Hillary Clinton should be the ones representing us? Is she the most qualified person you could think of to be president of the United States? In the universities of America, in the think tanks of this country, there are people who study every foreign policy issue that goes in every direction in the world. Things she never heard of, she knows nothing about, and she never even looked at because she was married to a degenerate. That's her only qualification, and that's enough. What does she know about foreign policy? Every time she mentions anything about foreign policy, you hear one disastrous remark after another that changes its mind an hour later, and then 2 weeks later she has another opinion. She has 32 opinions in a week and a half about the same issue.
If we in Congress don't end this war before January 2009 as president, I will. In the 4 years since the inspectors left, intelligence reports show that Saddam Hussein has worked to rebuild his chemical and biological weapons stock, his missile delivery capability, and his nuclear program. He has also given aid, comfort, and sanctuary to terrorists, including Al-Qaeda members.
The writing is on the wall, and it doesn't say mission accomplished. It says it's time to change course.
It is clear, however, that if left unchecked, Saddam Hussein will continue to increase his capacity to wage biological and chemical warfare and will keep trying to develop nuclear weapons.
Nearly 4 years ago, our president rushed us into war in Iraq.
So it is with conviction that I support this resolution as being in the best interests of our nation. A vote for it is not a vote to rush to war. It is a vote that puts awesome responsibility in the hands of our president. And we say to him, use these powers wisely and as a last resort. And it is a vote that says clearly to Saddam Hussein, this is your last chance. Disarm or be disarmed.
If I had been president in October of 2002, I would have never asked for authority to divert our attention from Afghanistan to Iraq, and I certainly would never have started this war.
This is a very difficult vote. This is probably the hardest decision I've ever had to make. Any vote that might lead to war should be hard. But I cast it with conviction.
She was in favor and against this war 30 different times. The fact that people are getting killed there and our children are laying down their lives for her, this is not even noticed to her. She only gives you an announcement every week of what's the most important political position that'll do the most for her campaign, what'll do the most for the lives of our kids. Means nothing for the country, means nothing. What'll be the best thing for her campaign? If it was not her campaign that counted and the soldiers counted or the fate of the war counted, then she wouldn't have a different opinion every 15 minutes. And it wouldn't be so strange that the opinion always matched the public opinion polls of that day. Look at her opinion. It matches the polls. It has nothing to do with the war. And you know why? Because she knows nothing about the war and doesn't care. She cares about getting elected. And even if it costs everybody's life. And Barack Obama. Now, let's be honest about it. There are a bunch of idiots who are immediately going to say, I'm picking on him because he's black, black. If I abuse somebody else, it's because I'm right. If I pick on him, it's because he's black. You're a sick moron if you decide that blackness has anything to do with it. It has to do with the fact that he knows nothing about this business. He was never there. And he couldn't walk into any company without any experience and say, hello, I want to run the company, when there are people with 20, 30 years experience like Senator Biden or Chris Dodd. They belong in that kind of a job. They know what it's about. They have a lifetime of experience in it. You walk into a job knowing nothing about it and say you belong there because you happen to be tall and black, and that's the only reason for his candidacy. He's got the right color. Till now, black was the wrong color. Now all you have to do is be black, it becomes the right color, and you become the hottest candidate. What's his other qualification? Think about it. I'll give you a month. If you could think of something, let me know. And if you could think of something, it'll be some idiotic, pointless, ridiculous, obnoxious answer that has nothing to do with reality. And that's what I think of anybody who talks about it in those terms. You're a sick human being if you want a disqualified person who doesn't belong at the job to take over this country. This country means nothing to you if he's your favorite candidate.
This was the place where America remembered what it means to hope.
And you spoke up for change.
We are choosing hope.
Change is what's happening in America.
Somebody somewhere didn't have some hope.
And our time for change has come.
The votes, the hopes that they hold in common.
To build a coalition for change that's derided for talking about hope.
Well, part of the change that's desperately needed.
But we always knew that hope is not blind optimism. People who love this country can change it. Hope is that thing inside us that insists.
That's the kind of change that I think we need.
Hope. Hope is what led me here today. When we've made the changes we believe in, hope is the bedrock of this nation. The one that can change this country.
That this time must be different.
That's what I got to say about Barack Obama. And let me tell you something about Hillary Clinton. On the other hand, I better not, because if I start picking on you, oh my God, you know what's going to happen? She's going to come out and say, ay, ay, face me, they're picking on me, oh, look what's happening to me, I'm working so hard, and I'm trying my best, because I don't care for me, I'm doing it for the country is going to go a yuck, long, the whole country is going to collapse without me if I don't wear a yuck, look what they're doing, ay, face me, the country!
It's not easy. It's not easy. I just don't want to see us fall backwards. It's not just political. It's not just public. I see what's happening. And we have to reverse it. And some people think elections are a game. They think it's like who's up or who's down.